Density bucket of science. It's a garbage pail, right? It's empty. But if you fill it with water and you put some on it, you get a pretty good idea of how density works. So in today's Everyday Science, we're going to take a look at density and figure out exactly how dense is an individual. Come on, let's go.
This is Jake. Jake's a very happy boy because he gets to go into the bucket. Now, we fill the bucket at 360 liters, which is the very top line there. Jake's happy about that. Jake then gets to get inside the bucket. And when Jake goes all the way down, he holds his breath, he goes all the way down. He displaces water. Why not, Jake? That displacement, as you can see, was from 360 liters to 335 liters. Therefore, Jake displaced approximately 25 liters. So how do we calculate Jake's density? Well, before Jake got into the bucket, we measured him, put him on a scale. He weighed 100 pounds. We convert that to kilograms, we get 36 kilograms. Do you remember how much water he displaced? It was 25 liters. To calculate density, we need to know his mass in grams divided by his volume in liters. Now, Jake's volume is equal to the amount of water that he pushed out of the bucket, so his volume is 25 liters. To calculate density, we need to take the kilograms and convert it to grams, which is 36,000 grams, and convert the liters to milliliters, which is 25,000 milliliters. Divide those two numbers, and you get a density of 1.44 grams per milliliter, which isn't surprising because water has a density of 1, so we should be relatively close to 1. So who else can we measure the density of? Well, just about anybody, actually.
Wait,
your phone! I'm just going to use my old phone.
Okay.
Oh my cool. God. Here we go. Ready?
One, two, three.
Rylan, get away!
Oh my God!
Cool.
70 liters. Okay. We'll let that settle. No, I don't want the pink towel. Give me the other towel. I'm going to ask Tay to do this. Tay is going to go all the way down, head under, exhale all the air.